This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I want to talk about long division and specifically about dividing by a one-digit number. I'll also do a video about dividing by a two-digit number and then another video explaining why long division works. Okay, but let's look at the first problem. So here I've got to divide 7,536 by 6. So I'll set this up as a long division problem. I'll make a kind of a box or a half a box and put 7,536 in the box. And outside the box to the left of it, I'll write the 6 that I'm using to divide by. And now the process goes like this. I take that 6, which is called my divisor, and I look at the number I'm dividing, and if I can divide it into the first digit, then I do that. So 6 can be divided into 7. It goes in one time. So above that 7, I'll write a 1 for the number of times that I can divide 6 into 7. Now I'm going to take that 1 and multiply it by the 6. So I take the 1, multiply it by the divisor. 1 times 6 is 6. I'll write that underneath the 7 and subtract it from the 7. So 7 minus 6 is 1. Now what I'm going to do is bring down the next digit. So the next digit was a 5. I'm going to bring that down and put it next to the 1. So now I've got 15. And now I start again. I divide the 6 into the 15. 6 goes into 15 two times. So I'll write a 2 in the next place underneath the over the 5, and multiply 2 times 6. 2 times 6 is 12. I'll subtract 15 minus 12. That's 3. I'm going to bring down the next digit, which is also a 3. So I've got 33. I want to divide 6 into 33. 6 goes into 33 5 times. Notice that to do this, you do have to know your basic division facts. Okay? So 5, then I'll take that 5, multiply 5 times 6, and that's 30. I guess you also have to know your multiplication facts too. Subtract 33 minus 30, and that's 3. I bring down the next number, which is a 6. So now I want to divide 6 into 36. 6 goes into 36 6 times. And I'm going to multiply that 6 by the 6 that I divided by. 6 times 36 is 36. I'll subtract. I end up with a 0. I've got no more numbers to bring down. So that means that 7,536 divided by 6 is 1,256. Okay. So let's do a few more, just to cover some maybe unusual situations we might run into. So let's try 8,124, and let's divide that by 3. Okay, so let's see what happens. I'll put 8,124. Into this box. 3 is my divisor, so that's outside the box, and I'll start dividing. So I'm always going to do the same process. I take the number I'm dividing by, the divisor, and I look at the first digit I have. If I can divide the divisor into that first digit, I do that. 3 goes into 8 2 times. I write that number above the 8. Then I multiply. So I've divided. Now I'm multiplying. 2 times 3 is 6. After I multiply, I subtract. So 8 minus 6 is 2. And then I bring down. I'm bringing down the 1 that's in the next column. So I've got 21. Now I start the process again. 3 divided into 21 goes 7 times. 7 times 3, I'm doing the multiplication part, is 21. Now I'm up to subtraction. 21 minus 21 is 0. And I bring down the next number. which is a 2. Now I start again. So 3 goes into 2, well, 3 doesn't go into 2. So 3 goes into 2 0 times. So I'll write a 0 above that 2. Then I multiply. 0 times 3 is 0. I have to subtract. 2 minus 0 is 2. And I bring down the next number and start again. 3, I've got a 24. 3 divided into 24 goes 8 times. 8 times 3 is 24. Subtraction, 24 minus 24 is 0. There's nothing else to bring down. And so my answer to this problem, 8,124 divided by 3, is 2,708. And I want to do one more problem. Let's see if I can get a problem where we end up with a remainder. Okay, so let's try 2,723 divided by 5. Okay, so I'll set that up. I've got that box, 2,723. 5 is my divisor. So let's see, I want to divide 5. I want to see if I can divide into the first digit. Well, I can't divide 5 into 2, so I'll try the first two digits. 5 into 27 goes 5 times. So I'll write 5 above that 7. Then I'm ready to multiply. 5 times 5 is 25. Next step is subtraction. 27 minus 25 is 2. And then I bring down. So I'm bringing down the next 2. Now I'm ready to divide again. 5 into 22 goes 4 times. I'll multiply. 4 times 5 is 20. Subtracting, 22 minus 20 is 2. I bring down the next digit, which is a 3. 5 into 23 goes 4 times. And 4 times 5 is 20. And I've got a remainder of, I've got 3 here, and I've got nothing else to bring down. So there's two things you may be told to do. One is you could just, after the number we have, the 544, you could write an R for remainder and a 3 after it. Or what you could do is you could realize the next thing you're trying to do is divide 5 into 3, which is like saying 3 divided by 5, or 3/5. So we can complete this problem by writing a 3/5, 3 over 5, after 544. So the solution is going to be 544 and 3/5 as the result of dividing 2,723 by 5. Okay, now, if you get used to this, and you're dealing with just dividing by one digit, by a single digit, you might want to check out short division as well, and I'll do a video about that. But I want to stop this here. I'm going to do another video about dividing by two-digit numbers, and then I'll do at least one more video explaining why long division works. Okay, so stick around for those. Take care.